Hi, everyone. It is my pleasure to be here today and to discuss with you ISO 30401 Annex B, also known as Relationship Between KM and Its Adjacent Disciplines. My name is Amy Williams. I am the Deputy Chief Knowledge Officer at NASA Jet Propulsion Laboratory. The following is the ISO 30401 standard structure. Today, we'll be talking about Annex B. Information management. Knowledge management and information management are often confused. Therefore, it's important to distinguish between the two disciplines. Knowledge management includes the codification of knowledge and therefore involves the creation of information. Once knowledge is codified, it is subject to information management processes such as storage and retrieval. It is also part of knowledge management, where knowledge management is concerned with the content of codified knowledge and ensuring that it supports good decisions and effective action, tailored to the user's context and understanding. Much existing knowledge within an organization is not codified and therefore not subject to information management processes. Even when knowledge is codified, it can never be captured completely, whatever resources are invested. Experience and insights, for example, are covered by knowledge management and not by information management. So although elements of information management are used in knowledge management, information management alone cannot meet the requirements for a knowledge management system. Data management. Knowledge management and data management are generally considered separate topics. However, aspects of data management that may be referred to as knowledge management include the combination of data through linked data and the use of algorithms to mine and analyze data and provide new insights. Business intelligence. Business intelligence is related to knowledge management as its goal is supporting creation of new knowledge and insights. This is achieved primarily by analyzing data and information to identify patterns. Customer relationship management. Customer relationship management handles data, information, and knowledge related to customers and other interested parties. Knowledge management can therefore serve as a means to better customer relationship management. Learning, organizational development, and training. Both knowledge management and learning, organizational development, and training disciplines enable organizations and individuals to understand the gaps between the present and the future in terms of knowledge needs. While training uses learning programs to bridge the gap at the individual level, knowledge management facilitates knowledge acquisition in various forms and levels. Learning services for non-formal education and training are already covered by ISO 29990. Organizational learning. Organizational learning and knowledge management can be distinguished in the way they address knowledge. In the discipline of organizational learning, knowledge is regarded as a means for organizational learning processes. In the discipline of knowledge management, knowledge is regarded as a means to achieve the organizational objectives. This might include facilitating organizational learning processes when appropriate to achieve the objectives of the organization. In this respect, knowledge management can be used as a leverage to attain organizational learning. Human resources management. Human resources management covers all aspects of the management of people in organizations, including optimizing the contribution of people to support organizational and stakeholder success and building the right capacity, individual and collective. Knowledge management further enables development of individual and collective capacity of those workers and improvements in their productivity by creating, sharing, and using knowledge. These two disciplines are dependent on one another. The worker relies on knowledge to perform their duties and increase their employability. Similarly, the organization relies on knowledge to deliver its objectives and thrive. Shared knowledge is powerful, but useless if workers do not apply it. A knowledge management system can enable greater productivity and performance. Appropriately, leveraging knowledge will more efficiently scale hiring practices and reduce impact of knowledge loss through voluntary and involuntary worker attrition. Innovation management. Innovation management and knowledge management are intrinsically related. Innovation management involves ideation processes and nurturing of creativity, facilitated by knowledge management activities such as knowledge sharing and development. Through these activities, new ideas emerge and new knowledge is created. Risk management. Knowledge management and risk management are closely linked in many ways, but remain separate disciplines. Both are disciplines for managing the intangible factors that affect the operation of an organization or project, and both need to be managed through the life cycle of a project. Acquisition of effective knowledge management, which is defined in Section 4.3 of this ISO, is one way to reduce or manage risk. There are ways to risk mitigation. Knowledge management impacts business effectiveness, performance, and reputation in other ways other than risk reduction, such as capability enhancement and decision-making and decision support. Both should be seen as parallel and complementary rather than overlapping. Did you know that knowledge management is complementary to quality management? Organizational knowledge is addressed in the Quality Management International Standard, ISO 9001, and is seen as one of the mandatory elements for establishing a quality management system. A knowledge management system, as defined in this ISO, is a means to achieve the requirements settled in ISO 9001, 2015, 7.1.6. In summary, explicitly connecting knowledge management with various disciplines generates synergy and integrated and improved management systems. Thank you so much.